On December 7th, 1941, Japan attacked the United States in Oahu, Hawaii. The major attack on Pearl Harbor caused the U.S. to enter World War II. Without the U.S. involvement, Germany would have probably won the war, changing the course of history. This all started because of Japan's desire to take over Southeast Asia. They wanted to take over freely and not have to worry about U.S. troops. So what Japan did is they attacked the U.S. so that it would halt the U.S.'s military. Japan started the attack at 7:50 a.m. Hawaii time. The attack lasted until 9 a.m. Hawaii time. Because of the attack, two ships got damaged and permanently could not be used again, such as the USS Arizona, shown in this picture, and the USS Oklahoma, shown in this picture. This ship, the USS Shaw, exploded but was able to be repaired. Japan's military leader, Hideki Tojo, was the mastermind behind the attack of Pearl Harbor. 2,403 U.S. civilians died, and about half of them were on the USS Arizona. By the 1940s, battleships were not the most important naval vessel. The most important naval vessels were the aircraft carriers because of the planes and weapons that it can store. Fortunately for the U.S., on December 7th, 1941, all of the aircraft carriers were out to sea, so Japan could not destroy them. However, Japan did not attack the United States' oil facilities, shipyards, and repair shops, so the U.S. was able to come back from the attack. The states were able to repair all but two ships, so basically the only damage done was to the people that died. During the Pearl Harbor attack, Japan failed to realize that the aircraft carriers had not been destroyed, so America's fleet had not been completely wiped out. Japan's attack had come on the U.S.'s radar. However, the technology was new at the time, so they just blew it off as a false alarm. The attack was so bad, the U.S. had to declare war on Japan, causing them to join World War II. The day after the attack, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt made a famous speech called the Day of Infamy to try and persuade Congress to declare war against Japan.
Mr. Vice President, Mr. Speaker, members of the Senate and of the House of Representatives, yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation, and at the solicitation of Japan.
After the United States declared war on Japan, the U.S.'s first attack on them was called the Doolittle Raid. On April 18th in 1942, a bunch of air raiders stormed Tokyo. The raid killed about 50 people, but it injured 400. The Japanese military was hardly affected at all, but it was okay because it boosted America's morale. The war in the Pacific started to come to a close with the Battle of Okinawa. In this battle, started by Japan, 12,000 Americans died, but more than 70,000 Japanese soldiers died. But the people affected most were the Okinawans, who had up to 150,000 people dead. This battle completely riddled out all the Japanese soldiers, and as ritual follows, the Japanese military leader committed suicide. The Japanese didn't realize that bombing Pearl Harbor would eventually lead to the downfall of the Japanese Empire. Facing an army with no leader that would not surrender, the United States bombed the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, with the first and only atomic bombs used on another country so far. Adolf Hitler, Germany's dictator at the time, applauded the attack on Pearl Harbor. He believed that the U.S. was just another country to rule, but this misjudgment may have cost him the war. Germany was winning World War II before U.S. joined. In fact, they had occupied Poland, Denmark, Norway, Belgium, the Netherlands, Luxembourg, France, Yugoslavia, and Greece. Germany invaded Poland on September 1st, 1939. The attack was the first in World War II. Because of the invasion, Britain and France declared war on Germany. There was little to nothing that they could have done to fight Germany. However, it did give confidence in other nations to join them and help. The U.S.'s involvement in World War II, including in the European theater, greatly impacted the final outcome of the war. This was illustrated in the Battle of the Bulge. The Battle of the Bulge was the last World War II battle. 120,000 German soldiers died. It caused the German soldiers to retreat, ending World War II for the European theater. The Third German Reich was over when Germany surrendered the Second World War early on Monday, May 7th, 1945. The defeat of Germany could not have been done without the Allied nations. The countries in the Allied nations included Britain, France, the Soviet Union, and the United States of America. These four countries were the main countries in the Allied nations. Without one or the other, Germany may have won the war. In the late spring, summer, and early fall of 1945, there were many victory parades. These parades celebrated the surrender of Nazi Germany and the freedom of the Jews. One of the parades took place in Moscow on June 24th, 1945. This is the largest military parade ever, with over 40,000 soldiers, including Soviet, French, British, and American. There were 1,850 military vehicles involved in the parade. Mitsuru Ushima, Japan's military leader, and Adolf Hitler both had very similar fates. They both were attacking other countries to expand their empire, both were attacking other countries when they died, and they both committed suicide because their troops were riddled out. However, Ushima committed suicide because of tradition, and Hitler committed suicide because of the Soviets' search. Japan attacking Pearl Harbor on December 7th, 1941 influenced the ending of World War II because if the Japanese were to not attack the United States, the U.S. would not join the war, causing Germany to invade other countries without having fear of American soldiers.
The United States was at peace with that nation, and at the solicitation of Japan,